Hi, Prabhu here. Welcome to modeling a complex shape in Maya. In this video, you learned about how to model a complex Samsung charger in Maya with perfect edge loop and mesh flow techniques. Okay, before we get started, we want to look out our reference image. So this is our reference image. So this is little bit complicated because the top portion is in rounded shape, so but in front portion in this charger has some sharp shapes, so we utilize knobs and polygons to achieve this shape. And we also model this charger plug point. So let's get started. Okay, open Maya. So go to create panel, knobs primitives, disable the interactive creation. So when you disable the interactive creation, I click on knob circle, it will automatically created in center of grid. So please make sure keep x-axis in this direction, z-axis in this direction. That means you will able to follow my instruction clearly. Okay, so go to channel box on layer editor, so and scale xyz to 5 and press enter. Now select the scale x and you want to give somewhat 11. So go to top view, so right click and choose control vertex, select this three control vertex and press R and scale in X like this. So same thing on right side, so select the bottom control vertex and scale in Z. So same thing on top and scale in Z. So now we got the basic shape of our top part. Now we need to add each corner of three control vertex, but we got only one and one, so we need to add. So right click and choose curve point, so click over here in this corner and use shift and click to add another one point. So use shift and add another one point, so each corner of two control vertex you want to add. So now we want to add this two sides, this four sides also same thing. So in this side we need to add one here, one from here, so same thing, one here, one from here, so same thing, one here and one from here, so same thing, one here and one from here. So that means you have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16 control vertex of newly we added. If you have any doubts, rewind this video and see it again. So go to knobs, surfaces, and go to edit curves and choose insert node. So when you right click on control vertex, I will show you what we got. So we got in center 3, here center 3, here we have 3, here we have 3. So see here, in center we got 3 control vertex, in corners we got 3 control vertex. Okay, so now go to control vertex and select this two control vertex and shift select this two control vertex over here on both sides and scale in X to maintain the edge should be so closer. So now select all 5 control vertex on top and scale in Z. So same thing on this side, scale in Z. So now go to object mode and select this curve. I will scale little bit in Z direction. Now go to perspective. So open outliner. So go to window and choose outliner. So outliner is very important. It is mainly used for clean our scenes. So I want to rename this curve as a top one. So you also make like that. That means you able to follow my instruction. I will rename as top one and press enter and press W and move this one as a in Y upside. So press Ctrl D. Ctrl D means duplicate, so it will create duplicate of top two. So and move this one as downside, so like this. So now we got only so this two shape, so one duplicate over here, another duplicate over here. We need to maintain two another duplicate to make this shape. So select the top to go in outliner and press Ctrl D and rename the top three curve as bottom BO double T OM 1 and move this one as downside and press R and scale little bit smaller in middle. So go to top view, select the bottom one. So we want to scale little bit like this, so and little bit in Z. So right click and choose control vertex. So select this three control vertex of corner, shift select this three control vertex of corner. So same thing on all other corners and scale in X. So that means you got somewhat like this. So select this two, one, I will scale little bit wider. So okay. So now select this four control vertex and shift select this four control vertex and scale in Z. So same thing on this two control vertex, shift select this two control vertex and scale in Z. So to maintain somewhat like this, so see here we got some bend over here. So I will move this curve manually. So if you have any troubles, just move this control vertex over this side. Okay, so now we got three control vertex on this each corners and three control vertex in mid. So like this. Now select this two control vertex in mid in this side and press R and scale in X like this. Go to perspective. Now select the in object mode, select the curve and move, press W and move little bit in Y. So now we got this area over here. Now press Ctrl D to duplicate and it automatically rename as bottom 2. Move this curve little bit in bottom. Now select the both curve and press R and scale little bit bigger in center. So little bit, so like this. Now we want to, we got the basic shape of this model as a curve, 1, 2, 3 and 4 control vertex over here, sorry, control curve. Now we want to make this curve as a model. So select the top one and shift select the top two curve and go to surfaces tab, go to surface and choose loft. Press 5 in keyboard to see the shaded mode. Now we want to check it will be normal or reverse. So go to lighting and choose two side lighting, disable the two side lighting. So see here the normal side is in inside, so we want to reverse. So select the lofted surface 1 and go to edit knobs and choose reverse surface direction. So the lighting should be reverse. So now select the top two control vertex over here and use shift and select the bottom one control vertex. Go to surfaces and choose loft. So now select the lofted surface 2. See it's a reverse direction. So now I select this lofted surface 2, go to edit knobs and choose reverse surface direction. Now select the bottom one control vertex, sorry, control curve. So if you cannot able to select over here, select in outliner and shift select the bottom two curve. So go to edit knobs and choose surfaces and choose loft. Now select the lofted surface 3, do same thing, edit knobs and choose reverse surface direction. So now we got the basic shape of our charger model. So now we need to convert this knobs as a polygon to make additional shapes of top and bottom. Now we want to convert this model as a polygon. So before that, we need to make some duplicates to make that one. So select the lofted surface 1, hold Ctrl in keyboard and select the lofted surface 2 and 3 in outliner. Press W and press Ctrl D, so it will make some duplicates. So I will move the three duplicate surface in X in this direction. So I will select all the original curves and lofted surface and press Ctrl G to group. So and select the group in outliner, and you want to disable this one visibility. So select the group and in visibility and choose 0 and press enter. So that means the group will be hide anytime you need. So select the group and press 1 in visibility and press enter means it will on. Now for our purpose we will hide this one. So now rename as a reference. So if you need means we will make this as another duplicate. So select our whole lofted surface over here. So now you translate X to 0 and press enter. So that means it will move over to center of grid. So now we have lofted surface of our knobs. So select all your duplicated lofted surface and go to modify, convert and choose knobs to polygon option box. So I will reset my settings. So now you want to choose two option, quad means four sides, and you want to choose control points. Control points means each face it will create each single divisions, and choose test leg. Now select the three polygons and move in this side. So select our lofted duplicate surface and press delete in keyboard. We need not this. So select your all knobs to polygon in outliner. So translate X to 0 and press enter. Now we want to combine this one. So see here we have extra divisions over here. So go to edge, double click on this edge, shift to double click on this edge. Now go to polygons tab because it's polygon. So go to edit mesh and choose delete edge by vertex. So go to object mode. So select this three polygon using shift, and go to mesh and choose combine. So that means the see here I will undo that. So when we have three polygons over here, when I choose mesh combine, so it will create some groups. So I want to delete this history to clear this group. So select the poly surface one, go to edit, delete by type and choose history. So it will clear that extra groups. Go to front view. So go to and choose vertex and select the two line vertex over center. So go to edit mesh and choose merge. So it will automatically merge that combined shape. So if you want to check, press 3 in keyboard. So check it will merge or not. So now I want to press 1 to see normal mode. So now I want to, so see here when I press 3, so it will be so softer over here and here. So we need to maintain some sharpness as we see in our model. So double click on this edge and shift to double click on this edge and go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So now decrease the offset of 0.1. So or 0.05. So if you are using latest version, so please adjust to the fraction amount. So go to object mode. So now we got that sharp shape. So if you want to check in object mode, press 3. So see here we got as we saw in our reference image. So now we want to make this top as a taper. See here. So now in press 1 to see in normal mode. So go to and choose edge, double click on this edge, and you want to go to edit mesh and choose extrude. So press W and move little bit upside, press R and scale little bit wider, so like this, and press W little bit upside, move little bit upside. So now double click on this edge, go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So it will automatically bevel what we need. If you want to adjust, please adjust fraction amount if you are using latest version. if you are using 2013 below, so you adjust our offset value. So we made like this only because it's so softer here. Now check it, go to object mode and press 3. So we got that shape over like this. So now we want to increase, so press 1 in keyboard. So double click on this top edge. So now we want to increase this one. So go to edit mesh and choose extrude. Press W and move upside over like this. Okay, so now go to edit mesh and choose extrude again. So you want to extrude, press R and scale in mid like this. So scale little bit like this. So now you want to fill this gaps over here. So double click on this edge and go to and choose edit mesh and choose mesh and choose fill hole. So now we want to connect this using interactive split tool. So go to edit mesh and choose interactive split tool. If you are using 2013 above, so you want to choose multi cut tool, choose interactive split tool option box and choose reset tool. So I will minimize the outliner, reset the tool. Now click and drag to that corner and click and drag and right click. So same thing, click and drag, right click, click and drag, right click. So same thing here. So click and drag, right click. So click and drag, right click. So same thing on opposite side, click and drag, right click. Click and drag, right click. So same thing over here, click and drag, right click. So same thing over here, click and drag, right click. So same thing over here, click and drag, and right click. So don't connect this mesh like this, so because it will create triangulate, so 1, 2, 3 sides. So I will undo that. So now you got 1, 2, 3 and 4 corners, so off all other sides. Now we want to make some duplicate to, so I will press 3, so it will make some what like this. Now I will press 1. So now we want to make some roundness over this corner. Go to control vertex, select this control vertex of all our sides over here. So same thing on here. So we want to select all our control vertex over here, go to top view and press R and scale in mid to maintain somewhat roundness. So go to perspective, so now it's create rounded shape. Now we want to extract this top portion, so select the top faces, face, go to front view, so select only the top face, so I will select like this. And control and select the bottom side. So you want to only select the top portion. Now go to mesh and choose extract. So before that I will open outliner. So see here, now we have only one mesh, so I will select only the top portion of our model. Go to mesh and choose extract. So that means it will automatically create our groups. So but we have two mesh separated in top and bottom. So I select the drag and select this both model in perspective. Go to edit and choose delete by type history. So now you want to extend this group of poly surface. I will select this this one and this one using control and press shift P to unparent and select this group and press delete. Now we want to make, see here, when I press W, the pivot is in center of grid. So I want to make this center of model. So select this poly surface 3 and go to modify and choose center pivot. So I want to move little bit upside, so go to front view and move little bit downside. So very tiny gap between here, so because we got very tiny gap between here, so now go to edit mesh and choose extrude. So you want to extrude upside, so for this thickness. Now you want to add one more extrude, go to edit mesh and choose extrude again, so little bit bigger. So go to edit edge, double click on this edge, so go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So it will add two segment and reduce the offset amount very tiny bit. So double click on this edge, middle edge, so it will select over low, press R and scale in middle little bit, to go to object mode. So now press 3 in keyboard to see what we got. So we need to add some sharp edge to maintain this corner. So I will select the poly surface 3, so click on this isolate select, so that means you will only able to see the selected mesh. So and go to top view, so select this vertex over here, use shift and select all the corner vertex and press R and scale in middle to maintain somewhat roundness, so like this. So select the all these faces, so using shift and select the all the face in center. So go to perspective. So see here, that we did not need the bottom face. So go to front view. So I will select all the bottom face. So in face mode. So shift to deselect the top face. Sorry, control deselect the top part. So select the face in top part, so go to perspective, so I will select only the bottom face and press delete in keyboard. So now we got only the top portion, so go to face and select all the top faces over here. So now go to perspective, go to edit mesh and choose extrude. So now press R and scale little bit in like this to maintain somewhat edge sharper. So press, go to edit mesh and choose extrude again. You want to extrude little bit in downside, press G, and you want to extrude little bit downside, and press G, and you want to maintain some edge sharpness over here, press G and press R and scale little bit over like this to make that edge sharper, so like this. See here, it will make like this. So that means you got three more edge loops to in this corner, So we also made this edge sharper. So double click on this edge to make as a loop. So go to edit mesh and choose bevel, and you want to decrease the offset amount of 0.1 or 0.2. So go to object mode, press 3, so to check it will be correct or not. So we will got this part like this. So now I re-isolate this model, so to make, press 3, so to make like this. So now we want to concentrate on bottom side over here, so press 1 in keyboard. So Now you want to make this bottom area. So double click on this edge and go to edit mesh and choose extrude and press R in keyboard and scale in Z and scale in X like this. So now go to edit mesh and mesh and choose fill hole. So go to object mode. So we want to connect it manually. So go to edit mesh and choose interactive split tool option box. So if you are using latest version, choose multi cut tool. So reduce the magnetic tolerance to zero. So I will click and drag to connect. So same thing, click and drag, click and drag. Click and drag, click and drag, and right click. So same thing on this side, right click. So same thing, right click. So click and drag, click and drag, right click. So click and drag, click and drag, right click. So same thing, click and drag, right click. Click and drag, click and drag, right click. So now connect only the center portion. So don't connect this one. So if you connect this one, here you got the triangle 1, 2, 3. So I will undo that. That means you got 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. So of all our corners. So now double click on this edge. So double click on this edge. So now go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So now you decrease the offset amount of 0.1 and go to object mode. Now you press 3 in keyboard. So you got that basic shape of our Samsung charger. So now we want to make this plug point over here, and then we want to make this one, and then we want to make this one. So first of all, we make this one. So go to perspective, go to create panel, polygon primitives, disable the interactive creation. So when I click on polygons tab, click on poly cube. So that means it will automatically created in center of grid. I will move in X over here. Go to front view. So it will be in this side. So I will move over like this. Press R and scale a little bit. So press 4 to see in wireframe mode. So I will move this one a little bit outside. So now select this control vertex and select this one and move. Sorry, select the vertex and move in X. So press R and scale a little bit smaller. Very tiny bit. So now we need to add some edge loops. So go to see here. We need 1, 2 over here. So now go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop option box, and I will minimize the outliner. So reset the tool. So now you want to add one more here, one over here. So see here, we got three another divisions of here. So I will add one loop, so second one and third one, so over here, so like this. Now go to this side. You want to need to add two more edge loop. Go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop. So same thing here and here of center. So now go to and choose face. So here shift and add over here, shift and add over here. So of three inside of this mesh. So go to perspective, press F to focus. So press 5 in keyboard to see the shader mode. So I will also go to front view. So you also made to add over here. Go to perspective, control deselect on mid areas, so over of front and back, so like this. Now go to edit mesh and choose extrude. Now you want to move in Z like this, so it will create like this. Now you want to add all the all the things to loops. So I will in object mode, I will select this model and isolate this one. I didn't want the back face, so I will select all the back face and press delete in keyboard. Now you need to add insert edge loop of all the sides. Go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop. So you want to add over here, so you want to add over here, so same thing on inside also. So over here, sorry, over here, so same thing on here, sorry. So you want to add all the sides, so here, sorry, here, 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 so same thing on all the edge corners, so over here, so and then here and then here. So you also maintain inside also, so zoom it little bit. So you want to add over here, add over here, so same thing over here, here, so same thing on this area, so here, here, same thing on here also, so here. Okay, now you also add one more loops over here and here. So now go to object mode and press 3 in keyboard. So it will maintain the shape of our charger. So see here, we need also over here. So go to see when I press 3. So here we got so smoother shape. So I will press 1. Go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop. So you also need to maintain over here and then here. Now go to object mode and press 3. So it will maintain somewhat sharper. So and press 1. So you need also over here. So go insert edge loop. So you also need to add over here and then here. So go to object mode and press 3. So that means you got that straight shape over here. So press 1. So you need also over here. So I will add over here and press object mode and press 3. So somewhat like this you got. So now I disable the isolate select. So now you got that basic shape of, sorry, our shape of our side areas. So now we need to make the plug point over here. Okay, go to front view, so press 4 to see our wireframe mode. So create panel, polygon primitives, disable the interactive creation. So that means when I click on poly cylinder, it will automatically created in center of grid. So I will move this over here and press R and scale in Y. So I'll press W, so over like this. Now I will move a little bit in X. So now go to control vertex, sorry, vertex, move this vertex over downside. Now go to perspective. I want to isolate this model. Press 5 to see the shaded mode. So I will isolate select this model. So go to and choose this vertex. So select all the face in top, only in top, and press W, sorry, press delete in keyboard. So now you need to add, go to front view. So I will disable the isolate select. Now you need to add two more edge loops over here. Go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop option box. So I will minimize my outliner. So I will add over here and another one to here. So now go to and select face of middle. So go to perspective. Now I want to extrude in inside. Go to edit mesh and choose extrude. So you want to move this arrow inside to create somewhat like this. Now go to Now you want to maintain this edges sharper, so double click on this edge, shift to double click on this edge. You want to do same thing on here, so double click on this edge, shift to double click on this edge, and go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So and choose offset of 0.1 or 0.2. So and go to object mode and check it's work or not, press 3. So now it's work. See here in bottom side we got like this. Go to front view. So now check, see it will be little bit smaller here. So I will select vertex of all over here and press W and move little bit inside. I will select this control vertex, vertex and move little bit downside. So I will select in mid and move little bit inside as we saw in our model. Go to perspective. So double click on this edge and go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So now increase my offset amount up to close of this edge over here. I will increase offset to 6 or something. So that means you got that rounded shape of here. So see here we got normally 1. So increase the offset amount up to close to this vertex. So I will increase the segment of 6 and press enter. Go to object mode. Now press 3 in keyboard to see what we got. So now we got the similar shape of this area. So go to front view. Now I want to duplicate. Press Ctrl D. I will move it over to this side. So now I will move little bit inside. So go to perspective. So now we got that the plug point shape. So I will move little bit downside. So okay, now we want to make only this one. So before that we want to group this all model. So go to outliner. So select all your polygons in your scene. So I will delete the reference, we need not this reference anymore. So I will select this reference and delete. So I will select all our poly surfaces and press Ctrl G to group. So and rename as charger. So now you want to rotate in x as 90, rotate x to 90, you want to rotate in negative side, I think. So you want to rotate as minus 90 and press enter. Now go to front view, press W and move it to top, exactly in grid, so top of the grid, see here. So you want to select the group and move. So now click on polyplane and scale little bit bigger, so to make our wire connection flow. So I will now want to make this this part. So it will be done using polygons. So go to top view. Okay, so I will hide this poly plane. So I will select this plane and click on display layer. I will add and disable this layer, so that means you will able to see grid clearly. Now I want to make this in polygons or nobs, anything you want, but I will use this part as a nobs and this part as a polygon. So we will already did this one, so we will take that one and connect to here. So first of all you need to make this one. So in front view, go to front view, go to create panel, nobs primitives, and disable the interactive creation and click on nob circle. Press W and move in X over here. press E and rotate in 90 degree. So press W and move it to top over like this. So now press R and scale a little bit wider. Go to control vertex, select this three control vertex, and so we did earlier like that. So select this one and scale in Z. So same thing on downside. So now go to object mode, now scale little bit smaller, press W and keep exactly in grid. Go to perspective, so press F to focus the curve, press Ctrl D and move it to little bit inside, and same thing you want to did another duplicate, so for this area, so press Ctrl D and duplicate. Now you want to adjust only this side vertex over here, so this one, and move it over here. So go to object mode. Now we want to make so select this one, shift select this one, shift select this one, three nodes goes. Go to surfaces tab, go to surfaces and choose loft. So see here we did not maintain this area, so as we saw in this mesh. So I will undo that. So I will select this curve and press Ctrl D and move it over to this side. So now select this one. So you want to select orderly, select this one, shift select this one, shift select this one, and shift select this one. So go to edit curves and choose surfaces and choose loft. So now you got like this. Now I need to add one more here, so press 1. So I want to convert this one as a polygon. So before that I will delete this one. So now I want to create it manually. So select this curve, shift select this curve, go to surfaces and choose loft. So now we want to reverse this surface direction, select this surface and go to edit nodes and choose reverse surface direction. So now select this nurbs curve and shift select this nurbs curve, go to edit nurbs, and so select this nurbs curve, shift select this one and shift select this one, go to edit nurbs and choose surfaces and choose loft. So like this. Now select this curve and go to edit nurbs and choose reverse surface direction. Edit nodes and choose reverse surface direction. So now I want to convert this model as a polygon. So select this one and shift select this one, and of lofted surface, go to edit, modify, convert nodes to polygon option box. Now I want to choose two options. So I will reset our settings, quads and control points, and choose tessellate. So now press W, so go to modify and choose center pivot and move this one in this side. So I will select all our curves and lofted surface and press delete. So I will make this one, so select this two polygons and translate to 0, so it will place in that area. So now I want to go to control vertex. So I will select this control vertex and move, so because it's little bit straight in corner. So now go to object mode, so select this one, shift select this one, and see here we have only the two mesh of this mesh. So go to polygons and mesh and choose combine, so it will automatically create a group. So select the poly surface 4, go to edit and choose delete by type, and choose history. The history should be cleared. So go to vertex and select the middle vertex of all sides. So go to mesh, edit mesh and choose merge. So and go to object mode and press 3 in keyboard to check it will perfectly merge or not. So it will perfect. Now press 1. So now double click on this edge. and go to edit mesh and choose extrude, press R and scale in mid. Now go to edit mesh and choose mesh and choose fill hole. So now go to object mode. Now go to edit mesh and choose interactive split tool option box. So I will minimize this. You want to give magnetic tolerance to 0. Click and drag right click. So click and drag right click. You want to maintain this edges sharper. So double click on this edge. Go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So you want to decrease the offset amount of 0.1. And go to object mode, press 3 to check it will sharper or not. So it will works. So now select this mesh and press 1 in keyboard. So double click on this edge, go to edit mesh and choose extrude, press R and scale in mid. So do same thing, go to mesh and choose fill hole, go to object mode, select the mesh, go to edit mesh and choose interactive split tool and magnetic tolerance to 0. Click and drag right click. So double click on this edge, go to edit mesh and choose bevel. So now decrease the offset amount of 0.1. go to object mode and press 3, so check it will works or not. So we got that exact shape of our model. So now we want to make like this, so it will very easy. So go to top view, press 4 in keyboard, sorry, go to top view, see the pivot is in center of grid. So I will go to modify and choose center pivot. Now we want to make the top part, so go to and choose cube. So press W and move this one into this side. So now go to vertex and press R and scale like this, very close. Don't merge because we need to maintain some quad shape. So I want to make like this. So select this tool one and make like this. You need to add one more edge loop over center. So go to edit mesh and choose insert edge loop option box and choose multiple edge loop option and choose number of edge loop to 1. So that means when you click, it will automatically create it in center. So select only this edge, don't select all other edge. So I will only choose the center edge. You want to move this one front side. Now you want to add one more edge loop to over mid. So edit mesh and choose insert edge loop. So you want to add one more here. So and you also add one more here. Sorry, I will undo that one. Go to edit mesh and reset insert edge loop option box and reset the tool. You want to add one more here and also here. So now go to object mode, press 3, so it will works. So but we didn't need the bottom face, so I will select all the bottom faces. See here, you want to select all the bottom face over here. So check on other all other sides and press delete. Now go to object mode and press 3. So go to top view and move this one, sorry, select this one and move over here. Go to perspective and move this one as in top, in front also, so like this. So as we saw in our model over here. So now we need to add that back part, so over this side. So it's very simple. So we already did that one. So select this one and press Ctrl D to duplicate. I will move it over to here and press E and rotate Z in 90, so minus 90, and press Enter. So go to top view. So I'll move it exactly where we need. So I will move in X and move in Y. So like this. Now you want to scale, press R and scale like this. Go to perspective, go to front view. Now I want to move this one downside and side. Press 4 and scale in Z. Go to perspective, press 5. So go to side view. So press 4 to see what we got. So press W and move exactly where we need. Go to perspective and press 5. So now you want to go to top and you want to match it clearly and press R and scale little bit. Press W and move it. So go to perspective. So see here we got that shape. I will reduce this distance. Go to top view, go to control vertex and select all over except the front. So I will move a little bit in X. So go to object mode, go to perspective. So now we got that part over there. So now we want to group this three areas. See, in outliner I will only select this three part. So and press control G to group. So now we got this three model in one group and rename as charger pin, so underscore pin. So now rehide this plane. So I will select the charger pin. So see here our pivot in center of grid. So go to modify and choose center pivot. That means the group pivot is placed in center of our model. So I will move it over to here. Now we need to connect some wires over here. Okay, go to top view. So now we need to add wires to this pin to charger. So go to create panel and choose CV curve tool option box. So I will choose CV curve tool option box. Now I minimize the outliner. So I want to choose 3 cubic and close the settings. Now you want to click over here. So here. So you want to make some randomness to like this. So I will, so if you have some mistake, so I will use backspace to undo. So I will create some randomness to connect this charger. So over here. So and press enter. Go to perspective. So see here it will be very flat to that area. So right click on outside. So select the curve. Right click on outside and choose control vertex. So select the control vertex in front. I will move it exactly where we need in center of our model. So same thing, you want to move this one little bit upside. So select this control vertex and move little bit here. So little bit inside of our mesh and move in X and Y. So you want to make this control vertex as center. So I will select this control vertex little bit upside. So that's it. Now go to object mode. So we want to make another one shape to travel that shape to this object. So select create nodes primitives, disable the interactive creation and click on circle. So it will automatically create an in center of grid. I will move the control vertex to this side, anywhere you want. So I will hide our display layer of our ground. So I will hide that one. So that means you will able to see the curve clearly. So go to control vertex. I will select this three control vertex and press R and scale in X. So same thing on here. Sorry, same thing on here. So same thing on here. So you want to do same thing on here. So select all things and scale little bit like this, because this wire is little bit thinner, so not exactly round shape. So go to object mode. So now I select this curve and shift to select this. Go to surfaces and choose extrude option box and choose, I will reset the settings. Now you want to choose tube, add path, add component and profile normal, all four this option, and choose curve range complete and output geometry to nodes and choose extrude. So see here it will be reverse, so I will undo that one. So first of all select the curve and shift, first of all select the knob circle and shift select the curve. Go to edit curves, surfaces, and choose extrude option box and choose tube, add path, component, profile normal. Now choose curve range to complete and output geometry to knobs and choose extrude. So that means the curve will be traveled to this mesh. So now I want to rescale this one. So I will select the curve and scale means see the mesh will be updated over here. So like this, now I will able to scale this one also. So like this. So if you want to rotate, so it will also rotate. So I will rotate this curve as Z of 90. Y of 90. So that means it will also rotate. So and press R and scale little bit thinner. So see here we got the exact shape. Now I want to reverse this direction, so select the surface. Now go to edit knobs and choose reverse surface direction. So when I turn on our ground, see here the mesh is little bit in ground. So press 4 to see our in wireframe mode. Open outliner, select the curve of inside, so it will have the history of our mesh. So right click on outside and choose control vertex, press 5, see our model. So I will select this control vertex of all our mesh, all the control vertex, shift and select all the control vertex up to here. So and press W and go to side view and move this one in Y as the top of grid. So that means your mesh will be, see here the mesh will be followed. So I also select over here and see here it will be like this. Okay, now go to object mode. So now select the extrude surface and go to edit, delete by type, and choose history and select the knob circle and press delete and select the curve of inside. So I will press 4 to see and delete. So without deleting history you cannot able to delete the curve. So when you delete the history, delete the curve. So press 5 to see the shaded mode. So now we got that wire shape of our charger model. Now we have only modeled this front part, so it's very simple. Go to front view. So now go to create panel, knobs primitives, and click on knob circle. So move this in X. So press E and rotate X in 90. So press W and move this one from so little bit as visible. So go to control vertex. Now I want to scale all these three things, all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Press R and scale little bit straighter and press W and move this one like this. So now you need to add, so I will select all this one and press R and scale like this. Now you need to add control or O vertex to here and here. So right click and choose curve point here to and shift and add here to. So go to edit curves and choose insert knot. So that means you will able to see here. Now select this control vertex and press W and move upside. So same these two things and press R and scale in X. So I will select these two things and press W to maintain the edge sharper. So now go to so select all this control vertex and press R and make stripe. So here also you need to maintain some sharp edge. So go to right click and choose curve point, add over here. Here go to edit curves and choose insert knot. Right click and choose control vertex, and you want to select all this control vertex over here and scale in Y. So that means the edge should be maintained sharper. So go to perspective, go to top view, sorry, press W, and you want to make this as front of this area. So here, so little bit inside over here, and go to perspective. Now you want to move, go to front view, and you want to move this in inside. So press 4 to see what we have. So if you have, go to trouble, go to modify and choose center pivot. So if you have this little bit big, so you also able to scale. So go to perspective and press 5 and move little bit downside and press control D and move this one in front. So that means you got two knob circle. So I will select front one and control select the back one. So press 4, see here I select the knob circle 1 and control select knob circle 2 in outliner. Go to surfaces and choose loft. So press 5 to see the shader mode. So I will select the 2 knob circle and press W and move. So the mesh also updated. So now I select the knob circle 2 and move little bit inside. So now press control D to duplicate and press R and scale in mid. So like this, so little bit like this, so very small like this. Now select this one, knob circle 2 and control click on knob circle 3 in outliner. Go to surfaces and choose loft. So and select the lost knob circle 3 and press control D and move the knob circle 4 inside. So now select the knob circle 3 and control click on knob circle 4. Go to surfaces and choose loft. So that's it. So now you want to select all the things of our pin and go to edit, delete by type and choose history. So now select all the knob circle in our scene and press delete. Now you want to select all the knobs model, so except the wire, and use middle mouse and drag it to our so select that one and move it. So select using control and press control, hold middle mouse button and drag it to charger pin group. So we'll drag it to charger pin group. So that means when I click on charger group, so now we got that pin is connected to our model. So now we finish this model. So we add somewhat detail in it. See here we have some checker shape over here. So I will select this extrude surface 1 and right click and choose sorry. I will hide this ground. So I will select right click and choose isoform. So I will click and drag over here. So over here, go to edit notes and choose insert isoform. So that means it will got some resolution over here. Here also you need. So right click and choose isoform. Click and drag over here and go to edit notes and choose insert isoform. So that means you got some bended shape over here. So you need also over here. So right click and choose isoform. Here you need. So click and drag and on this curve. Go to edit notes and choose insert isoform. So you also need over here. Right click and choose isoform. Click and drag on this isoform over here. Go to edit notes and choose insert isoform. So we want to make for our wanted areas, needed areas. So now I rehide this ground layer. So now go to shading and choose wireframe on shader. So you able to see our model clearly. So if you want to hide, go to shading and disable the wireframe on shader. Okay. So that's it guys. We got the complex shape of our Samsung charger. So now we want to group. So I will select all these three, all these things, and drag it to our charger group. So select control select these two groups and middle mouse and drag it to our charger group. Now when I click on charger, the all the things are updated. So that's it guys. So we will see on next video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will continue posting of modeling a complex shape in Maya. So we will see on next video.